Good morning, one and all. Welcome to the Python programming workshop. In this session, we will going to discuss problems based on list and tuples. Great guys, in previous lectures, we will see how to create list and manipulate the list. What are the tuples and how to use tuples? How tuples are immutable and lists are mutable? What are the different properties of list as well as what are the different properties of tuples? These are both are of type collection. So let's check some problem statement based on list and tuples. Great. So first problem statement, that is merge two list into list of tuples. So given thing is two list, write a Python program to merge the two list into the list of tuples. So what is the input? Input is the L1 list containing some elements, then L2 is a second list containing some elements. Now what is the output? Output is a tuple. Okay, so tuple containing 21 comma A, 22 comma B and 23 comma C. These are three different tuples separated by comma, and again it is a list. So merge two list into the list of tuples. Great. I hope you understand the problem statements. So let's move on to the code part. So what is the code? How we can write the code? So create your own method. That is definition. Merge is the name of the method. Merge to list, list 1 and list 2. You can give any name to the list. Then how to merge it? So what is the code for that? That is the body of merge method. So for give any variable name I in the range, what is the range? That is the number of elements in that list 1 and list 2. The number of elements are 3. So calculate length of the list 1, which gives you length of the list 1. So what is the list 1's length? Suppose 3. So 3 elements are there. So 0 to 3, and 3 is excluded. So loop is executed for 0, 1 and 2 only. That is 3 times. And fetch the elements of I index. What is the I index element? That is 0th. First is 0. So list 1 of 0th value, that is 21. Suppose list 2 of I, that is the first index value of list 2, that is A. And make that tuple, that is parenthesis. That is parenthesis indicates it is a tuple. So create the tuple and assign to the merge list. And list, so it is a into the square bracket or subscript operator. Great guys. Whole code is together. So let's understand the meaning of that and return the merge list to the caller function. So list 1, list 2, then print merge list 1 and list 2. That is the function call inside the print method. Great guys. Main task is to this. First, take one by one element from the list 1, add to this, separate by comma, then add second element from the list second, first element from the second, and make its tuple, and then tuples list. So that is merge to list into list of tuples. Great guys. So hope you understand the code. So right, let's move to the PyCharm IDE and check it. So merge to list. Okay, great guys. So this is our code part. Here merge is the name of the function, list 1, list 2. So first create two list. You can add any list values 1, 7. So make the tuple of 1, 7. Make the tuple of 2, 8 and 3, 9. And display it as a list. So for, what is the code? That is the main important part. To pass two list to the merge function. Then for loop executes for 3 times. That is length of the list 1, that is having 3, length is just 3, 0, 1, 2. Then one by one create one tuple of list 1's index 0, list 2's index 0, that is 1 and 7. Make the tuple and its tuples again make the list by square and save it into the merged list variable and return that merged list variable and print into print method. Let's check. Run it. Okay, great. So what is the output? 1, 7, yes. 2, 8, this is tuple separated by comma. Then 3, 9 is another third tuple separated by comma, and it is again a list. Great guys, hope you understand the code. Clear? Yeah. If you mention instead of tuple here, you have to give square bracket. Then what happens, guys? Let's check whether it works or not. So what it gives you? It gives you tuple. It gives you list members and list of list. It is called as nested list. Great. Guys, hope you understand that. Clear? Okay. So move to the next solution. So using zip method also, we can merge two list and then typecast into either tuple or list. Great. So what is the purpose of zip? Zip method is a map the similar index of the multiple containers so that they can be used just using as single entity. Great. What is the meaning? Actually, zip function return a single iterator object having mapped values from all the containers, which are the containers you have to pass, that is list tuple, to the zip function, then one element from the both and make its one single iterator object value. Great guys. So how to use that zip function? So create again merge function, pass two list to that merge function, then zip method, then pass list 1 comma list 2. These are two different collection objects. Then each element from the one first and second is collected and form a tuple. If you use tuple, then it forms tuple. If you use list constructor, then it creates the list. Great. And automatically this saved into the merge list, return merge list. Okay, so the again the code is similar. Great guys, the main part of the body of the function merge is this using zip method. Understood what is the zip returns? It returns single iterator object containing mapped values from all containers, which is passed as a argument to the zip function. Great guys, hope you understand the code. So let's move on the PyCharm IDE and check it works or not using zip method. Okay, so I hope you understand it. So similar merge method, zip. If you want to print it into tuple form, then use the constructor as a tuple. Great. So these are the two list, list 1 and list 2. You can use any non-homogeneous data elements also in the list. Yes, it is possible. We can store non-homogeneous elements into list also. Merge function, call to the merge function. Merge is a user defined function. After that, passing to list, zip function, list 1 and list 2. These are two collection types. Then list, what zip contains? Zip take one element from list 1, one element from the list 2, and makes it either tuple if you typecast into tuple or either list. Okay, here we can typecast into tuple, so it becomes tuple. So let's run it and check whether it works or not. Yes, great guys. So first all tuples, and after tuple you can typecast into tuple, so all the tuples again make the tuple. But what is our problem statement? Make it as a list. So which constructor we have to use? List constructor, guys. Yes, run it. Now what happens? Okay, so these are the tuples and these tuples are collected into a list. Hope guys you understand that problem statement. Great. What, how the zip function works? I think you know that. Clear? Yes guys. So this is a problem for merging two list into list of tuples. Great guys. So move to the next problem statement. Second, that is convert a list into tuple of list. What is the meaning of that? Let's check. We are a given list. Okay, two lists are given. The task is to convert the list into, what is the task? Convert the list into tuples of list. For example, what is the input? Input is a first to third. Okay, any non-homogeneous list. Then what is the output? Output is each element is in the form of list separated by comma, and again it is a tuple. That means convert the list into tuple of. Okay, this is a tuple. Tuple of what? List. Each element is in the form of list. Okay, hope guys you understand the first problem statement. So let's move to our main source code. So what is the source code? So initialize any list, first to third, okay, non-homogeneous data element, then output is equal to tuple name. So name is in the form of list for name in the input. So take one element from the list input and make its individual list by using this code, and again typecast into tuple. So it's again becomes tuples, list of tuples. Great. And print output. So let's check whether it works or not using PyCharm IDE. So in PyCharm, first list, first to third, this is a list, then pass this input for name in input, take each and every element, make its list, and again save it into the tuple. This constructor is a tuple, so output is of type tuple and the tuple get displayed. But each tuple, this tuple contains what? List, each element in the form of list. Great guys, hope you understand. So let's check. The first element is in the form of what? List. Then second element in the form of list. So lists are separated by comma operator, and again whole is in the form of tuple. Great guys, hope you understand this problem statement. If you want to convert it into list again, then use constructor as a list. So this list name, each and every element becomes a list, and that list is again become a list. Just check whether it works or not. Great, first, two and third, these are three different lists, and it is again a list. Okay, so guys, if you want to check what is the length of this list, how you can check using length method. So length, okay, so how many elements are there in the list? Great guys, check once again. So number of elements are 3, because each element is in the form of list and 3 lists are present in the list. Great, I hope you understand what is the meaning of this. So let's move to the next way of convert a list into the tuple of list. So what is the second way? Using list and map function. Great, so it is an input, this is a one list, then convert zip into input. That means first, two and third, these are converted into what? Either list, okay, tuples or list. Then convert a map into map with the list, comma, okay, and then in the form of tuple, convert it into the form of tuples. The output is in the form of tuple containing list, number of list, and list contain each single element. Great guys, hope you understand. So using PyCharm IDE we will check it. Okay, so let's run this program. So let's check whether what is the output. Okay, first, two and third, these are three different lists, and list is inside, each element of the list is inside the tuple. Great guy, instead of tuple, what we have to use? We have to use list also. Okay, so list, if you use list constructor, what is the output? Yes guys, it is all elements in the form of list. So each element is in the list form again, and all these three elements again in the form of list. Great guys, hope you understand the problem statement. Clear? I think if you have any doubts regarding any problems, then let me know and write the query in the comment box or chat window. Thank you for watching my video.